running draw. And that's some things that most people never thought they'd see together. Okay. It's funny, the people that have never used NextStep in the audience are going, well, what's so amazing about that? And the people that have used NextStep are going, my God, I thought I'd never live to see the day. In addition to, obviously, the user environment, we have all the developer tools running. And what I'd like to do now is show you Interface Builder running. Here's a simple window. And I'm just going to build something very simple here. I think I'll just take a text field and drag it in. And I think I will go over here to bring up a font panel. Oops. And let's just go ahead and change this to a bigger font so we can all read it. Oops. Select this. All right. And let me drag a slider down here. And oops. And let me bring up an inspector. Let's see here now. And let me select the slider. And I'm just going to set this to go from 0 to 100 to make this simple. And then I'm going to take my connection and, just like I always do in Interface Builder, connect it to the text field. And we'll just say take an integer value. And if everything is working right, I should just be able to say test this. And here we are running Interface Builder inside Microsoft Office. We're finding that this stuff runs really well on Windows NT. And it is exactly the same code that we are running on Unix, with obvious changes for integration with the Windows system, drag and drop, the print, the save, et cetera, et cetera. And your application source code is exactly the same. The draw application has 100% the same source code as it does for OpenStep on Unix. So we have a truly portable environment. A lot of our customers want to use the mixed environment between Unix and Windows. However, we must also say that OpenStep running on Windows has gotten us into some projects at these customers that we never would have gotten into were we not running on Windows. So we're pretty excited about this. We have a tremendous amount of customer interest, and we think it's going to be a pretty successful product. Okay. So that's OpenStep. You can see it running in the booth, and I think you'll be pretty excited about it. And it is on schedule. Matter of fact, we're a little bit ahead of schedule. So OpenStep is one of the major pillars of where we're going. And the OpenStep partners, Hewlett-Packard, Digital, Sun, us, are really excited about it. Now, in doing OpenStep for Windows, we wanted to be a great Olé citizen. And so we developed technology to let our distributed objects look just like Olé objects. Matter of fact, really become Olé objects so that we have seamless integration between Olé objects and our objects. And that's all in OpenStep for Windows. When we got this all running, somebody said, my God, you just run this on two Windows machines and you have distributed Olé 2 years before Microsoft. We thought, this is very interesting. And so we are bringing a product to market at the end of this year, which is distributed Olé. And it's hot. And we couldn't figure out what to call it. We thought about calling it just distributed Olé, but we figured Microsoft would, you know, have a trademark issue with that. So we couldn't call it that. And so we thought about calling it D-Olé, but we figured that same old trademark issue might come up. And we thought about calling it Dole or Dole or something like that. That was probably a problem. We thought about calling it Bob. But then they went and trademarked that. So we figured they couldn't have a problem with Bob Dole. But in the end, we decided to provoke a little controversy, and we've decided to call it D'Olé. Distributed Olé today. And let me tell you a little bit about this product. Now, this is what we have been shipping for the last 4 or 5 years. As you know, Next is the only company to ship distributed objects in production, even today. And we were certainly the first 4 to 5 years ago. And what we do today is you can have any client, whether it be NextStep running on an Intel PC, NextStep running on a Sun or HP workstation, objects can message other objects transparently that live on other machines over the network. And you don't have to worry about the networking gunk, and you don't have to worry about finding them, and you don't have to worry about anything. It's just as if you messaged an object that was right next door. And what most people do with this is they message objects running on servers. And so we have our object model, PDO, running on all the servers from HP, Sun, and DEC. And this makes it very, very easy to build multi-tier client server applications. Matter of fact, NextStep is by far the easiest way to build multi-tier client server applications because of this completely transparent distributed object model. Well, what we have done is this. We've said, you run Dole on your PCs, and we'll be shipping it for Windows NT around the end of this year. And there's no reason we can't ship it on Windows 95 first half of next year. You run this on both your machines, and literally all your applications do is make an Dole call to Dole, and they message their Dole messages distributed to other machines. That's it. Nothing special. They just make Dole calls. They have to know nothing about Objective-C. They have to know nothing about PDO. They have to know nothing about NextStep. They have to know nothing about OpenStep. All they have to do is know how to call Dole. Well, what knows how to call Dole? Well, Visual Basic, Visual C++, Delphi, anything running on a Windows machine. And it's even cooler, because now on a Windows machine, it's really hard to write a client-server app. It's really hard to write a distributed application if you want to move some of the processing to another machine, because all of these tools I've just mentioned, like Visual Basic and Visual C++, have no notion of distribution at all. Well, guess what you can do? You can do this. You can write your front end on a Windows machine running using Visual Basic, let's say. Call Dole. Dole will automatically pass that Dole call over to a server, let's say, an HP server running PDO, and message back-end NextStep objects on that HP server. And the front end on the client knows nothing about any of the back-end stuff. And so, generically, this is what you can do. You can have Windows machines talking to Windows machines. You can have Windows machines talking to servers, Unix servers running PDO. Or you can have it talking to NT servers running Dole. Or you can have it talking to OpenStep or NextStep clients, which have PDO embedded within them. Any permutation here works seamlessly. And I'm going to demonstrate two of these permutations to you. I'm going to demonstrate Windows NT to Windows NT, and I'm going to demonstrate a Windows NT client to a Hewlett-Packard server running PDO in just a moment. Dole is in beta now, and we'll be shipping it by the end of this year. Okay? So let's see if it works. I have two NT machines here. I am going to be driving from the one on the left, and I have a simple OpenStep on NT application, which simply has a host name over the network, three buttons, one that says connect, one that says create chart, and a third pop-up that selects the type of chart, and I have a slider here. So the first thing I'm going to do is push this connect button, and when I push it, it's going to go out over the net and send an Dole message to this other NT machine right next to me, the screen on the right, and which is going to launch Microsoft Excel. So I say, connect. And this is over a standard local area or wide area network, TCP/IP, so it even works over the internet. So there's Microsoft Excel, and I can push this button, and it loads in a file, creates a bunch of data, and builds a chart. And I can say I want a different type of chart. I can say, well, why don't you give me a line chart? Or why don't you give me a column chart? Or why don't you give me a 3D pie chart? And I can change this and actually update values in real time. You see up there?